when she was actually hundreds of years old. But the true length of a person's life is always a matter of dispute. Some, we can justly say, they live precisely the 68 years allotted them on the tombstone.
Others are hundreds of years old, but we call them 36. It's a difficult business, this timekeeping. And nothing more quickly disorders time than contact with any of the arts.
Such as this. Your very presence haunts me. When our eyes share a gaze, it entrances me. In the purest form, you are the embodiment of beauty. You are a masterpiece, something to be presented with velvet and violins, leading up to see crystallized light dispersing across a golden ceiling. This is what you deserve. Like a philosopher, you are a great thinker, codes flying from your fingers like you're fluent, working by candlelight and self-deprecation because you don't think you're smart enough, but you are. And though you've a subtle arrogance that I imagine led to your surprise when you found out you're not always the greatest, you are fragile, and I strive to protect that. Even in God's most beautiful creation, you are flawed and human. I choose to be blind to it. I remember how I loved you, by you slowly stepping in time to Romantic era Latin tongue. Sanctus, requiem. Covering your face like you had a secret, it brought me back. Back to the year of us. Then it was cinematic perfection, novelistic excellence. Then I could sleep, to die in peace. That that August night to the Opus. Humor me. But I think he loved me once. Each have their exits and their entrances, and one man in his time plays many parts, his acts being seven ages. At first, the infant, mewling and puking in the nurse's arms. And then the schoolboy, with his satchel and shining morning face, crawling like a snail unwillingly to school. And then the lover, sighing like a furnace with a woeful ballad made to his mistress' eyebrow. And then the soldier, full of strange oaths and bearded like the pard, jealous in honor, sudden and quick in quarrel, seeking the bubble reputation even in the cannon's mouth. And then the judge, in fair round belly and good cape and lined, with eyes severe and beard of formal cut, full of wise instances and modern saws, and so he plays his part. The sixth age shifts into lean and slippered pantaloon, with spectacles on nose and pouch on side, his youthful hose well saved, a world too wide for his shrunk shank, and his big manly voice turning again towards childish trouble, pipes and whistles in his sound. The last scene of all of this strange, eventful history is second childishness and mere oblivion. Sans teeth, sans taste, sans eyes, sans everything. singing. I want to be an actor, a great actor. I want to be a dancer. A 5, 6, 7, 8. Trees and barns and the night. But people? People. I don't know. Chattering, spiteful, always telling lies, and yet love. What of it? Flies on the ceiling. Sasha.
Here, another cell came in.
She's still in the king's cell.
A single cell, a real cell.
The great rings of silence beat up and down in the empty house.
All was lit as if for the coming of a dead queen.
The house is at your service.
wrong, Nathan.
Wrong? Yes.
Not yourself.
I'm not sure there is such a thing, Your Highness.
Don't be silly, Orlando. You are many things to many. To me, you are a delightful boy in silk stockings. Apparently, you have changed. But no matter, you dare to have one.
I think at this present moment, I would just like to be one thing.
Poppycock, don't be a bore, Orlando. You were never a bore in silk stockings.
What's death like, Your Highness?
That. Nothing really, just kick inside. My sinuses are unbelievably clear. Oh, dear.
I long for death, sometimes.
You are always wanted on that doing it. When I knew you, you were filled with fun. Exquisite, bursting with it.
I remember.
Perhaps it is the spirit of me.
Upstairs, or why we come back down again. Our most daily movements are like the passage of a ship on an unknown sea.
Look, Orlando! There is a large goose in the garden!
Where?
Oh, just there.
The wild goose and the secret of life is... Tell me, what?
A small kiss. For an old time's sake.
Orlando banished these thoughts. She remembered at the start she was married. Charmody?
She was married, true, but if one's husband was always away, sailing around the world, was that marriage?
And if one liked him, was it marriage? If one liked other people, was it marriage? If one still wished more than anything in the world to write poetry, was it marriage?
She had doubts.
But she would put it to the test. She flopped down under the old oak tree. She took to her poem. She looked at her ring. She looked at the ink pot.
Did she dare?
Hang it all. Here goes.
She plunged her pen deep in ink. To her enormous surprise, she wrote. The words were a little long in coming, but come they did.
But does it make sense? And then I came to the field with the springing grass, snaky flower, scarved in purple, like Egyptian girls.
You have a husband. Are Egyptian girls really necessary?
Leave me alone.
And all the time she was writing, the world continued, through wars and other calamities.
She listened for the sound of gunfire at sea.
No, only the wind.
There is no war today.
And so, she wrote, and wrote, and wrote.
What's life? She asked a bird.
Life! Cried the bird!
Finally, Orlando dropped her pen and stretched her arms.
Done! It's done!
And the poem wanted to be read. Human beings have become necessary.
Yes.
The first stroke of midnight sounded. The cold breeze of the present brushed her face with its little breath of fear.
Shalmardine? Here, Shal, here I am. He came as he always did, in moments of dead calm.
When the wave rippled, the spotted leaves fell slowly, and nothing moved between sky and sea.
And then he came. Shalmardine?
And the 12th stroke. Midnight sounded. It was, in fact, the present moment.
Orlando's mind began to toss like the sea.
I can begin to live again.
The little boat is going through the white arch of a thousand deaths. I am about to understand.
Shuffles in. There's an old man sitting next to me, making love to his tonic and gin. He says, son, can you play me a memory? I'm not really sure how it goes, but it's sad. Sweet, and I knew it complete when I wore a younger man's clothes. La 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 la. Sing us a song, you're the piano man. Sing us a song tonight.